පෙරට වංචාව දූෂණේ තමන්ගේ එකම වෘත්තිය බවට පත් කරගත්තු චෞර වලලක් අපේ රටේ ක්‍රියාත්මක වෙමින් තිබෙනවා.
There is a ring of thieves that is engaging in fraud and corruption as an occupation in this country. What has this ring of thieves done? They have plundered the assets of the people worth up to millions and billions. The losses caused the employees provident fund amounts to 23 billion. Who bore the responsibility? The losses caused in treasury bond issuances from 2007 to 2015 amounts to 11 billion. Who bore the responsibility for this? The hedging deal caused losses running up to 80 billion. Where is the thief? They were aware that the economy of Greece was collapsing. There is a thief who went and deposited funds worth $1 billion in Greece at the time. Where are the punishments against them? The Navy says that it had earned a profit of 8 billion in 2 years. These profits had been diverted towards corrupt businessmen at the Avangard company. If we look at international media reports on our country, it was revealed in the British courts that former Sri Lankan Airlines CEO Kapila Chandrasena had obtained a commission when purchasing 10 aircraft and 4 aircraft on a lease basis. The funds had been deposited to his wife's account. The commission amounts to $2 million. This translates to 400 million Sri Lankan rupees. Where are the punishments of these thieves? Now it has been revealed that certain thieves at the central bank had paid CIA moles in the US using funds of the treasury and the central bank. This figure stands at $6.5 million. This means that the public funds worth nearly 13 billion rupees had been spent on a CIA agent. The New York Times had reported that China Harbour and China Merchant Companies had spent funds on behalf of Mahindra Rajapaksa. Before this report, we had shown how funds had been deposited to the account of Pushpa Rajapaksa and how funds had been spent for Mahindra Rajapaksa's election campaign. Who are the individuals in the China Harbour Company? What is this China Merchant Company that is acquiring our ports? What are these companies constructing power plants? We know that the government that came into power after that caused a loss of 11 billion to the entire country through the issuance of treasury bonds on the 28th of February, just 51 days after being elected. Where are those thieves? 546 Prados were under the custody of the customs. They were released under a small penalty of 100 million rupees. Where are these thieves? When they served as finance ministers, storage facilities were registered under the names of their wives. What sort of a country is this? It has been revealed that millions of losses had been caused due to the import of cattle. The losses caused at the paddy marketing board has exceeded 40 billion. We know that funds of the Central Cultural Fund and the National Housing Development Authority have gone to waste as well. People in villages are lacking basic sanitary facilities. There are parents who are bedridden, unable to purchase medicine for themselves. People in rural areas have been affected badly as wild elephants that encroach into villages destroy their belongings and their lives as well. At the same time, people are ending their lives as a result of being unable to repay microfinance loans. There are people who are unable to afford meals due to unemployment. A ring of thieves has plundered the wealth of the people. Shouldn't we fight against the ring of the thieves? We will continue to fight against these corrupt individuals, even if they establish many commissions or prisons or murder be in broad daylight. I wish to emphasize that I will not stop my fight against these corrupt individuals. Some claim that I have power. If I had power, many individuals would be in prison. We know how these individuals amassed wealth. What was the mandate of the commission? That was to investigate allegations of victimization against state officials, members of the three armed forces and the police. But the case pertaining to the Avangard owner was taken up. Is he a state official? Cases concerning Udayanga Veerathunga, Nalaka Godaheva, Jali Vikramasurya and Rohitha Bogolagama were also taken up. Are these state officials? A case was filed with the appeal court against taking up the matter on Avangard. The argument was that it could not be investigated by the commission. But the report has named me as a respondent in the Avangard case. This is what the commission has done. The commission was due to finish accepting complaints on the 7th of March 2020, but on the 25th of October, Thirunadesan, and on the 23rd of that month, Yoshitha Rajapaksa filed complaints. These cases were heard immediately upon filing the complaints. Therefore, their conduct is entirely biased. On the 8th of December, the report had been published. Generally, we know that the duty of the commission ends after publishing the report. After the 8th of December, no member of the commission apart from Pali Abeyaratna entered the premises. What did he do? He distributed the report among the accused and allowed them to include whatever they wanted before issuing a report again on the 7th of July. The commission submitted 3 reports. Where is the interim report? The report states that the recommendations in volume 1, 2 or 3 and the interim report must be implemented. Where is the interim report? Upali Abeyaratna cannot prepare an interim report. The term of the commission ended on the 8th of December. The interim report was handed over on his way to the president's legal advisor, Rohan Adhira. That was how this is done on the 7th of January. We know that a case is pending on the High Court against Avangard. A counsel named Janaka Bandara is appearing for the Attorney General's Department in that case. Janaka Bandara raised questions from Avangard in court. That is how a judicial process takes place. But in the commission, Avangard questions the lawyers. How can this happen? We are thankful to Dappula Diliwera. The Attorney General did not send his lawyers to this commission. These cases are being heard in courts. This is the first time in Sri Lankan history in which court cases were heard by commissions. We have submitted details concerning this ring of thieves. What is my connection to this? Former Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe asked me to report facts to him. I did so thrice. If Gotabaya Rajapaksa asked me to report facts to him on the sugar scam, how a loan worth 3.1 billion was used to purchase cigarettes, and also the MIG deal, I will visit him immediately and provide him the details. We will continue our fight against these corrupt individuals who form this ring of thieves.
ඒකට කොමිෂන් සභාවලින් ප්‍රජායිතිය ගරු නියෝජකතා නැගතුණු ප්‍රජායිතිය මට මගේ ප්‍රජායිතිය අනේ කොතල ගහගන්න කියන ගෝඨාභයගේ හරිද ප්‍රජායිතිය වලින් දේශපාලන කරන මිනිස්සු නෙමෙයි අපි අපි මේ
We won't engage in politics for our civic rights. We engage in politics for the rights of the people. Therefore, regardless of any threat that we have to face, we will not stop our struggle against corrupt individuals.
මේ දූෂිතයන්ට ඇරෙව කරන අරගල නැත කරන්න බව මතක තබා ගන්න.
One mission, one channel, and one more thing, 1 million subscribers on YouTube.